Hi everyone. Hopefully all of you are just doing fine. When I create this video, Indonesia is still fight off the COVID-19. It means it has been 2 months we are stuck at home. But that's okay, it is life. We have to keep on moving, okay? Well, actually, I really miss you all standing in front of you in the class and giving the lecture. But that's okay. Let's just pray this pandemic will be over soon. Well, the last topic that I asked you to discuss is about taking the sample by lottery and generated random number. Right now, we're going to discuss sampling with and without replacement. Are you ready? Let's get started. Sampling without replacement. It means in taking the sample from a population, you don't replace the first item you choose before you choose a second, third, or until you get the number of the sample that you want from the population. And this will be questionable. Why? Let's see. So for example, we want to take 10 samples from the population. So by following the procedures as we had already discussed, or you have already watched it in the previous videos, then the procedures. First, write all the population names with different folded paper for each. It means there are 100 population. So we will have 100 folded papers because all the name will be written separately, 1, 2, 3, 4, until all of them are written in a folded papers, I mean for each. Okay, great. What I mean, okay, 100 population. So we need to write all the names of the population, pull it in a folded paper. After that, we continue, mix and shake the folded papers in a box or container. We shake it first, okay? And we take 1, 2, 3, and so on, until we have 10 samples. And here will be the probability. If we take the first sample from the box, okay, then the probability will be 1 per 100. And if we continue taking the second sample, now the probability is lesser. It will be 1 per 99, I mean, because we have already taken 1 from 100, then 99 is left. Yes and no, English students, you don't like mathematics, do you? Okay, I'm lucky because when I was a student, senior high school, I am from IPA, okay, that is Indonesia, or science class, okay. But it's okay, this is simple, just follow me explaining this topic, okay. And if we continue to the third sample, take a look at, now we have the probability 1 per 98, and so forth. We continue until we get the all the sample that we want. So see that now we have 10 per 100, or it equals with 1 per 90. So the probability is going to be lesser and lesser and lesser. And if we do this, then this is contrary to basic definition of randomization, in which each element has an equal and independent chance of selection. But by following this, that is contrary to this rule, because as we had already discussed, the probability is not equal from the first, second, and so on until we get all the sample from the population. That's why this is questionable. Therefore, we need to do taking the sample by replacement. So this is the second, okay? Sampling with replacement. It means the selected element or sample is replaced in the sampling population until the sample determinant is obtained. It means if, for example, we want to take 10 names from 100, the probability from the first, second to the 10th will be equal. So this is it. Okay, example. Again, we follow the procedures. Okay, the procedures in the beginning are just similar, but the next step is different, in which the first selection probability is 100. Then, after taking the sample, the first sample, okay, open it, write down the name, save it first, and flip the paper again, put it back to the box or the container. Okay, save, write to name, then put it back to the box, then shake before taking the second sample. Okay, so you do this until you get 10, okay, or the number of the sample that you want from the population. So see that, okay, first, second, third, the probability is equal, okay, and so forth until we get the last sample from the population. But in this case, okay, there will be a chance that a sample or the name that we take from the box or container is selected more than once. Yes, that will be right. For example, you have taken the name and write it, put it back. Okay, it means there will be a chance that name which has been taken before, okay, will be taken twice, thrice, and so forth. If it has happened, just put it back, check again, and then take until you get all the sample that you want from the population. So this is it. So that's simple, right? Okay. So why do I say in the beginning, if you do the first procedure, that is questionable, because okay, the probability is not equal. So it is better, okay, to do the second one. It means you take the sample by replacement, take, put it back again until you get all the sample that you want from the population. So simple, right? Okay, that's it for our discussion, and see you. Bye-bye.